Hey, Alias here, and this is another update for my Thunderbolt script. Before getting into details, I'll quickly tell what's new. First is the lightning bolt. They come in different shapes and sizes. Then I tweaked the sounds. There are some new sounds. I've also changed the fire names and made few adaptations, so it'll be easier in the future to tweak the script. I've created a few textures for puddles, and I added the screen effect for lightning during the day. Now about lightning bolts. They come in 26 shapes, I think, which are picked randomly. They are pretty big, some of them are 1000 meters in length, and they are generated around random playable characters. Depending on your view distance settings, you'll see the lightning bolts or not. If the playable character around which the lightning is generated is far away from you, most likely you'll not see it. However, you'll be able to hear the echo of the thunder. When it comes to a single player mission, the story is different. Since the only playable character is yours, the lightning will be generated around you, and you will pretty much see all of them if your view distance is set to at least 2000 meters. As I said, I did some changes in the sounds. Now there are two sounds for each lightning. One is for when you are close enough to hear it, and one sound will be the echo, which is delayed based on how long it takes for the sound to travel. This delay is actually generated based on the speed of sound. In the last update, I've introduced the puddles. Now they come in several shapes. I made a few textures. They are pretty faded, so they can fit pretty well with any terrain. What I basically did was to retexture an object from Eden called Blood Pool. As you can see, they also have a bit of reflection. Again, you don't need a mod to do this. This Blood Pool is the biggest flat object I found in Eden which can be textured via scripting. If you know of a bigger object, please let me know, because I would love to make bigger puddles. As you may know, the light sources are not rendered in Arma during the day, or they are not visible anyways, which makes sense, because when the sun is up, it is too bright, and any other light source is not bright enough to be visible. But this is a kind of problem when it's cloudy and the sun is behind the clouds. In reality, the light of the lightning bolt will bathe the surroundings. Since I cannot use the light source in Arma, I've simulated this using a post-process effect, which is not perfect, but I personally like it. If you don't like this feature, there is a variable you can set to false. If you open Alias Thunderbolt STF file, here at line 25 you have this day screen effect variable. Set it to false and it's off. Of course, during the night we can use a light source in Arma, and we also have the good old storm clouds, which I also tweaked. I think they look nicer now, but it's a matter of taste really. This was it. If you like my work, feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel or my Steam page. If you have suggestions, let me know in the comments below. Until next time, have fun and happy editing!